Hello and welcome to this look at the HUD and the compare tool within Boris Continuum with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris Effect. Now, both of these tools are going to be used in interesting ways to speed up our effects creation and to make sure that we're not pushing any effects too far. So let's pop over to the other side and see what we can do with the HUD and with the compare tool. Compare is one of the most useful features you can find in Boris Continuum. So I'm going to come over to my first shot here, which is bringing coffee. And as you can see, it's a bit soft, so I'm going to add a bit of sharpness to it. And to do that, I'm going to use my BCC Magic Sharp. I'll just apply that onto the clip itself. Now, as with all of the Continuum filters, we do have a number of presets to work with. And my favorite for Magic Sharp is the high threshold sharp edges, which generally tends to get me into the right place just with a single click. So that means the only thing I have to worry about is how much sharpening I have to do using the sharpen amount. And it can be very easy and very tempting to over sharpen at this stage. So it's worth being able to see what the clip looked like before we applied an effect. Now we could toggle things on and off using the bypass, but there's a better option as well. If we have a look in the effect editor, we can see we have the compare twirl down, which we can use, and I can choose which compare mode I want to do. I can use a side by side, which gives me my before and after. I can use compare. So we look at the full clip just divided by the wipe line, which I can change either by clicking and dragging in my viewer window or by using the wipe slide in the effects control. I can also compare it with another layer, which we're going to do in just a moment. But for this one, I'm going to compare it side by side. And I can use the wipe slide amount to slide over to an area that I think is important. I can also use the right offset slider to slide the after side into an area that I think is even more interesting. And at this stage, I can just change my sharpen amount so I can see the difference that we sharpened, but we're not over sharpening. Nice, easy way of seeing a before and after. When I'm happy, I can just turn my compare mode off again. And there we are. Again, quickly using the bypass to show before and after. Now I can use compare to look at a different layer as well. So if we take a look at our clip here, what I want to do is to match this to our incoming shot, which is this spooky nighttime hut. So I could use any number of color effects, but to get a fast look here, I'm actually just going to go to fast film process. And I can apply that as a filler layer over the top of the image there. And let's just bring the effect editor back up again and come up to my effects browser and find something that gets me into the right sort of area. So I'm looking for something that's kind of cool. Pale blue is looking all right. Night interior should be around about the right size. But I think with this one, I'm going to use blue wash. Hit apply on that. And let's see how close I've got. So in compare, I'm going to turn my compare mode to compare with layer, and I'll have a new dropdown to show what I want to compare it to. By default, it looks at the layer below, and because I've used a filler layer here, the layer below is the original layer, so I want to go two layers below. So now I can see my spooky hut. And again, just change where the wipe is going to be, and I can come over to the post-process areas here and maybe just give this a little bit more contrast, change up the balance and hue just a little bit, move that over there and maybe touch the saturation down. And if I'm happy, I'll just turn the compare mode off one more time and let's just fudge this along. There we go. Let's just move that over there and play that back again. See how that cuts together. And I think that's looking all right. So that's how simple it is to use the compare controls in Continuum within the Avid Media Composer host. Now the HUD's an intuitive way of controlling effects directly within our viewer, and different effects have different HUD controls depending on what we need to do with them. For example, if we come over to our first clip and look at this blue screen, I'm going to want to key this out. And Boris Continuum has a number of different keyers available, but I'm going to use the Primatte Studio keyer, and I'll just grab that onto my clip. Come into the effects mode, and you see with Primatte Studio, I have a whole UI available to me. So this means that I can click on auto analyze and Primatte will go along and see what colour my background is most likely made of, and come down the bottom and see how good that matte actually was. And if I need to, I can use any of these other tools, such as Clean Background, to just tidy up my key directly within the interface, just by drawing over it there. I can even use a matte status to just really check to see if I'm missing any sort of small areas which wouldn't otherwise be visible to me. And once this seems fine, I can just click on Final Composite, and I've got a very nice convincing key with very little work. And for straightforward keys, or for doing the first part of a key, I never have to go over to my effect editor to do any sort of twirling down or changing anything in here. I can do it all straight in the viewer using the HUD. Other effects show the HUD up in a slightly different way. So if I come into a blur and have a look at my BCC blurs here, I can choose a directional blur and put that over the top of my animated background. So you can see again, I have a HUD directly within the viewer, so I can change my blur amount, I can change my blur angle, all within the viewer here. Now, if I wanted to do anything different with this, I can easily come over to my effects editor, and for example, if I wanted to change the apply mode, I could change the apply mode to screen straight here and just find the effect that I'm after. So we're not limited to only doing corrections in the HUD, it just shows up the most common controls that you might want to adjust. Now let's say we wanted to change what widgets are available to us on the viewer. We can do that over on this panel in the effects controls on the right hand side. So we can choose the standard UI widgets as we have now. We can change this just to scale and position, or to crop, or we can turn off the UI widgets. So if we want to see the Boris Continuum ones on, we just turn it on at the top button. And we want to turn the widgets off, we turn it on at the bottom button. And as we'll see later on, these widgets will also change and update depending on where we are within the effect. So if we do have things like the pixel chooser turned on, which we're going to talk about later, then you'll see that we also have the pixel chooser available to us in the HUD as well. And that's our quick look at the HUD and compare within Boris Continuum. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Avid, subscribe to the Boris Effects YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If we're missing something, then let me know in the comments below. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects, and thanks for watching.